Welcome back to STS. In today's video, we're going to continue with the derivative. Today's shortcut method is going to be the sum and difference rules. Basically stated, the sum and difference rules just means that if I were to take the difference quotient and use it on this entire equation here, that would be the same as taking the derivative of this first term plus the derivative of the second term plus the derivative of the third term. And notice it says the difference rule is the same thing. If I take the difference quotient of the whole thing, of this whole equation, that would be the same as taking the derivative of this first term minus the derivative of this second term, which would just be the difference of those two derivatives. All right, so let's begin by just using some of the other shortcut methods to find out what the derivative of f of x is. So here our notation is f prime of x is equal to, we're going to use the power rule to start. It's going to bring down the 3, multiply it by the coefficient of 4, and this power has to be decremented by 1, so that's going to be x squared. And then do the same thing here to my next term. I'm going to write my coefficient of 2. It's understood that the power here is 1, so I'm going to put times 1. And then I'm going to decrement the power of this x term, and that's going to make that 0. And then here, when I take the derivative of a constant, that there itself is 0. Now I need to simplify. 3 times 4 to give me 12, x squared. 2 times 1 to give me 2. And then x to the 0 power is 1, and again plus 0. So here I have 12x squared plus 2 is the derivative. Now let's go over here to this g of x, and let's find what g prime of x is. Again, use the power rule where the 2 comes down out front. My coefficient is a 9, so I keep that, and I decrement the power of this x variable. So that's currently second power, so it moves down to the first power, minus 4. Again, I'm going to bring down the power, which is a 1, and I'm going to decrement the current power, which would make this here 0. Again, I simplify. 2 times 9 to give me 18x minus 4 times 1 to give me 4, and x to the 0 is 1. So here I have 18x minus 4. So those are my two derivatives for these two functions. And now let's do the proof to just show that using the difference quotient is in fact the same thing as taking the derivative of each term. So let's start by using this new, or just a different notation for derivative. So d over dx, and we're going to take the f of x plus g of x. And to write that using the difference quotient, it's going to be the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h plus g of x plus h minus f of x minus f of x plus g of x. And I need to show these two here in parentheses, and all of this here has to be divided by h. All right, what I can do in this next step is let's go ahead and rewrite, but I'm going to distribute this negative to both of these terms. So again, I have f of x plus h plus g of x, and when I distribute, this becomes a negative f of x and a negative g of x. And again, everything is divided by h. And now I see that I can separate these into two separate difference quotients. Right now it's shown as one, but I can separate it. So I have the limit as h approaches 0. So I've got f of x plus h, and I've got my minus f of x, and that there is over h, plus the limit as h approaches 0. Now I'm going to take this portion, or that term, g of x plus h minus g of x, and again all of that is divided by h. And in fact, this can be rewritten as f prime of x plus g prime of x. So we see that when I take the derivative of these two functions, where I'm taking the derivative of the entire function, that's the same thing as taking the derivative of each one of the terms. Alright, so that sums it up for this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook. Also, subscribe to that YouTube channel because you're able to get all the updates and all the new videos. And as always, thank you for watching.